Have pity on an old war veteran. How are you?
Many of the Argonian slaves have returned to their tribes.
The land of the Argonians is a strange place indeed.
Goodbye.
Yes?
Good morning.
I
ran into some goblins in the woods not long ago. Nasty little beasts.
Disgusting creatures. I hope to never see another.
Good day.
I'm Ardaline. I'm the guild's advanced trainer in alchemy here in Braville. I don't like talking to people much, but Kudai's helping me get over that. That's why she put me in charge of selling alchemy supplies. Take your time. I can show you some new things. Bye.
Good morning.
Delphin Gend, creator of the celebrated Enemies Explode spell, advanced trainer in destruction, and mage destined for great things. Bye.
Hello there, associate. You're here for a recommendation, I presume. Are you prepared to earn it? I'm afraid I haven't had time to prepare anything conventional. I'm very preoccupied with this situation concerning Ardaline. Perhaps you can help with that, however. I can't directly get involved for fear of embarrassing the poor girl. I'll need you to have a little chat with Varen Vamori, and you can learn something about the power of illusion in the process. Don't say anything to her. I don't want to embarrass her further. Once this is all taken care of, I'll speak to her privately. I don't understand it. Some ridiculous male thing, I suppose. He's been bothering Ardaline every day for a while now. He even stole her mage's staff. Perhaps he thinks it's amusing. I don't know. But it needs to stop. It's making her miserable. It's more symbolic than practical, but each carries great significance to its owner. You're going to get Ardaline's staff back. Take this charm scroll. With it, you should find Varen more receptive to questioning. Don't come back without that staff. Varen Vamori should give it to you once you've persuaded him, if you understand me. Make sure Varen hands over that staff.
Hi there.
What do you want?
Oh.
What do you want? Hello, friend. What can I do for you? Take your time. I don't know what to say. All I want is for her to care about me, to feel the same way as I do about her. But she doesn't. I try, and it just doesn't matter. It makes me furious sometimes. I've never laid a hand on her, either in anger or... I've never hurt her, okay? All right, I admit it. I took it from her. I don't know what I was thinking, honestly. I was trying to tell her how I feel, again, and she wouldn't even stop to talk to me. I just got so angry. I was a little ashamed afterwards, but I didn't know how to apologize or give it back. I wish I could. I'm afraid I don't have it anymore, you see. I sold it to a friend of mine, Saurus Aranum. He lives in the Talos Plaza district of the Imperial City. He's the one who has Ardaline's staff now. If I still had it, I'd gladly give it back. You'll have to talk to Saurus Aranum if you want it. Old, worn, and wicked. Wet, wounded, and wild. Empty as the eastern horizon. Dusk on the Nibbon. Solemn and bitter as the grave. Tell Ardaline I'm sorry. What is it?
Please, go ahead.
Any luck talking with Verin Vermore yet? It should be no trouble at all once you use that scroll. He sold it, huh? Well, this just keeps getting worse. Very well. I presume he gave you some indication of where the staff is now located. Take these and go resolve the situation. And of course, please keep this just between us. Get that staff back, associate. Greetings to you.
What is it, citizen?
All right then, I'm listening.
I needed some cash, so I went to see Gen C.
She gives good prices for your old equipment. Have you heard any word about the other provinces?
The news has not been good. I've heard it said that the Deidre have overrun the town of Aldrum. The entire town has been destroyed.
It seems it is a dire situation throughout all of Tamriel.
Goodbye.
You have the eyes of a trained marksman.
Good to see you. Good to see you.
The King and Queen Tavern isn't a bad place to stay if you're visiting the city.
The King and... The Queen is a fine place, and it's much more reasonable than other places in town. Good day, stranger. Saurus Aranum is my name. Look, I can't just give it to you. I paid good money for it, after all. I'll tell you what. You give me at least a portion of what I paid for it. Say, 200 gold, and I'll give you the staff. That's a good deal, right? I wouldn't offer it to anyone else, just you. So, what do you say? I'll just take the money from you, then. And here's your staff. Now, since our business is concluded, you must excuse me. Good day. A pleasure to speak with you. Oh, he's that wanted criminal. Isn't he a master thief? I hear he's dangerous, too. I've heard that the beggars spy for him. I don't know. Just take a walk around. Buy something. Plenty of stores. Why'd you come in the first place? You've already purchased the staff, friend. There really isn't much more to say on the subject, is there? Do you believe any of that talk about more Oblivion gates opening all over the place? Take your time. Take care.
I'm Erisari Aranim. Soros is my husband. Goodbye.
How are you today?
We're looking for recruits. Interested? If you're interested, see Velena Danton in Coral, or Azan in Anvil, or Burz Grokash in Shadenhall. Bye.
Welcome. What's new with you?
Do you have the mage's staff associate? Ah, wonderful. I shall be most pleased to return this to its rightful owner. Thank you. You needn't tell me the details of what was involved in getting it. It's perhaps better that I know nothing about it. Your actions for the guild more than merit a recommendation. I shall send it to the university promptly. And to thank you more personally, I shall teach you this spell. You may find it useful in certain circumstances. Please, I'm in desperate need of help, and
I think you're the only one that I can turn to. It seems that these are turbulent times in the land of the Dunmen.
Good.
I heard people saying they ran into goblins around here not long ago.
Hello, Assassin.
I can't stand those things.
Nice to meet you. You'll have to speak to Dargael about that.
May all your travels be safe to those creatures.
Goodbye.
You too.
You choose to share your time with me? You humble me.
Hello, associate. You seek wisdom from me, child? Ah, no, you seek words. Words are difficult. They come and go. The voices, though, so loud they are, they drown out the words. Without my amulet, my stone to lock the voices away, the words will never come and stay. Would you lift your hands to help another? To help me find the words? Then seek Agata, child. She will see the path and set you on it. I must rest. She may be young, but her heart is old and wise. It guides her well through these troubled times. Farewell, child.
Yes? Is there something I can help you with, associate? I'm surprised she discussed it with you. She wanted to keep it from the others. I should speak to her about that. Yes, her seer stone is missing. It's the one thing that has kept her visions at bay. And without it, they're nearly crippling. She can't function. We haven't yet spoken to the others, for fear they would be less than accepting of her situation. Perhaps it is time, though. I will continue to tend to Dargael. Can you speak with the other mages and find out if any of them have seen the stone? Let's do business. Always keep your magic equipment charged. Good day.
Fine. Nice to meet you. All I heard was that it was important to Dargael, and it was missing. Kalthar didn't tell me anything more than that. Agata is the first person I go to when I need something. Maybe I should talk to Dargael instead. But I just don't feel comfortable doing that. She was a very powerful mage once, from what I understand. Hard to imagine that, honestly. May all your travel...
What? She's the one you want to talk to if you actually need something to get done around here. I don't even know why Dargael is still around. I've heard she was put in charge of the Leowen Guild Hall as a favor, not because she deserved it. That doesn't seem right, does it? Well, well. Word is finally spreading, is it? They won't be able to keep up this facade much longer. Yeah, I know all about it. I overheard Agata and Dargael talking. And you know what? I'm glad it's gone. Why should we be forced to work under someone who's only kept sane by a magical trinket? Haven't we sacrificed enough already? She shouldn't even be here anymore. Hell, the only reason her father ever fit in anywhere is because he kept a low profile. And look what it got him. Years of service to the Empire, and not even a tombstone over his head. Huh. At least he was able to maintain the illusion of sanity. I know. I get way too fired up over this. It just annoys me that she's in charge of the guild when she's clearly not fit, that's all. What, haven't I said enough already? Just let it go. Once someone finally realizes what's going on here, maybe things will change. Necromancy may be legal in Cyrodiil, but few will openly admit to practicing it, now that the Mages Guild has banned it. Take care.
Greetings, Evoker.
What's new with you?
I heard people saying they ran into goblins around here not long ago. I can't stand
those things. Did you hear that someone played?
Another prank on Jean Frazorik
and Gruma. Disgusting creatures. Yes? Is there something I can help you with, associate? So Kalthar overheard us, did he? That explains why he's been so cranky lately. But we never said anything about DeGale's father. How would he know anything about that? If there's some sort of connection between the Seer's Stone and DeGale's father, I don't know about it. Maybe if you ask her, it will jog her memory. In the meantime, I'll keep an eye on Kalthar. Bye.
Hello, Assassin. You seek more from me, child? It is as I have seen. I know what you would ask. You would bring light to that which is in darkness, bring silence to the voices so loud. I know where you must go. Bloodbrand blew and dragons flew high. Under broken towers and broken bodies it now lies, waiting to be found. What was my sire's must be mine if you would have the words you seek. You must go and find his stone.
What's the news from the other parts of Tamriel?
I've heard nothing good. In Morrowind, they say...
Look, just stop right there, all right? I can't let you leave with that amulet. I need it right now. I took the other one, and that should have been enough. I shouldn't have to go through all this just to get rid of her. It's not even as if I was going to keep it forever. I was going to give it back to her once I'd gotten what I wanted. That's not so wrong, is it? Once she helped me advance out of that place and step down, then she could have it back. Why did you have to get in the way? Why are you trying to ruin everything? Your worst.
Hello, associate. Nothing has changed, child. The voices still cry out, and I am unable to hear. If they can be sealed away, our work may begin. Found it, have you? Silenced the hands that betrayed and took what was mine? Then let me have the stones so that the voices can be shut out. Ah, child, I thank you for helping me. With the voices quieted for now, the words you seek have come to me. You shall have my recommendation. Though I must warn you, I've seen things in your future. Things which may be, and things which will be. It will be up to you to decide the fate of many. Life and death are strange things, easily manipulated, and both will be altered by your hands. Be seeing you.
It's you.
What's going on with you?
I ran across a couple of mud crabs.
What do you want, a job? If you want it from me, you'll have to join the Fighters Guild. Not that I'm sure you can cut it. The Fighters Guild is always looking for new members. If you've got a clean record and don't have a bounty on your head, we may be able to use you. Are you interested in joining? Good, I guess. You're now an associate in the Fighters Guild. Report to me or Azan and Anvil for contracts. And don't screw up. Goodbye.
How are you? I'm Magician Orentor of the Mages Guild. I divide my time between the Chaiden Hall Guild and my own private studies at Willowbank. You'll need to see Falcar about that. Take care. What is it, associate? Don't tell me you're here for a recommendation. Don't waste my time if you're not ready for this. Are you prepared to do what is necessary to gain a recommendation from me? Very well. We shall see how prepared you actually are. There was a particular ring of burden I was testing some time ago. Another stupid associate somehow got his hands on it and managed to misplace it. If I didn't know better, I'd say he purposely tossed it down the well behind the guild hall. Why he would do such a thing is beyond me. You will retrieve this ring for me. Should you manage to do so, I shall consider sending a recommendation to the university. The well is locked, so you'll need the key. Dietzen should have a copy of it. Now get moving. Bye.
Well met. I'm Dietzan, Magician, Mages Guild, that is. Don't tell me Falcar has given you the same task he gave Vidkun. Oh, dear, I'd say more, but... Well, Falcar is the ranking member here, and I don't feel comfortable talking about him. I'm sorry. I'll tell you what. Find me when Falcar's not around, and then we'll talk. After we've spoken, you can have the key. Believe me, this is important. I can show you some new things. As I've said, I just don't feel comfortable talking to you about Falkar. Forgive me. Bye.
Good to see you. Good to see you.
Hello, associate. A pleasure to speak with you. We can talk, so long as Falkar is out of earshot. If I didn't know any better, I'd say he's trying to get you killed. He gave poor Vidkun the same task, and we never saw him again. I'm reasonably sure there's a connection, but I can't prove it. Do be careful. I'd hate to lose another useful associate. Here's the key, and something extra. I don't know if it will be of use to you, but from what I've heard of Falkar's ring, it may come in handy. And if you find out anything about what happened to Vidkun, let me know, will you? You too. Hello, associate. I'm afraid some things have happened while you've been gone, associate. It may affect your recommendation. Oh, just drop it anywhere. I don't think he really cared about it. I think it was some sort of sick joke on his part. I'll admit, it's my doing. I couldn't leave well enough alone. And after you'd left to go after that ring, well, I'm just so tired of the way we've all been treated by Falkar. I was worried about you and angry about Vidkun, so I confronted Falkar directly. He was furious when I told him I'd helped you, and then when I threatened to report him to the Council of Mages, I thought he was going to kill me. He flew into a rage. I didn't even understand some of his ranting, but he said that our days are numbered, and then he stormed out. I don't know if he ever wrote your recommendation. I'm sorry. I didn't expect this to happen. Perhaps you should go look and see if he did write one. You should check his room in the living quarters. If you see the note or anything else unusual, let me know. I'll gladly send it to the council. Farewell. How do you do?
Good to see you. Greetings and salutations.
What's this? Black soul gems? Oh dear, this is worse than I'd expected. All right, I'll just take these from you. I'll need them for my report to the council. Now, you didn't find any sort of recommendation? Very well. I shall write one myself and include it in my report to the council. In light of the circumstances, I believe they'll find it more than adequate. Our hall doesn't offer much in the way of training. I can teach some basic alteration skills, but that's about it. Take care.
Hail, good citizen. How can I be of service?
Greetings, Sister Bosmer.
Hello. Hello, associate. It seems you've obtained the final recommendation you required. I have received recommendations from all the local guild halls in Cyrodiil. You've done well for yourself. You may now enter the university. As a full-fledged member of the Mages Guild, I now also promote you to the rank of Apprentice and grant you the robe of the Apprentice. Take a moment and try it on, then we shall speak of what comes next for you. come to the real work at last. You have, no doubt, seen some of the worst the Guild has to offer. As much as we try to hold mages to a higher standard, they are only human. What I hope you will now see is that while the Guild can be disjointed and misused, it can also achieve some wonderful things. Now you have an opportunity to engage in more meaningful tasks and continue with your advancement through the Guild. You do not yet qualify for further advancement in the Guild. Before you can begin work for the Guild, you'll need to do something for yourself. Every mage carries a staff. It is crafted and enchanted by the Guild and is a symbol of status. You need such a staff. The wood used for staves comes from a grove to the northeast of the Imperial City, near Wellspring Cave. Several mages tend to the grove and should be able to assist you. Speak with either Zarasha or Illette when you arrive, and choose wisely. You shall have a true mage's staff soon.
Hi!
Let's get this over with.
Why don't you die?
Take that! I'll have your head, you filthy Norn! Am I supposed to be impressed?
Everybody needs a copy of the Black Horse Courier.
I've heard that the great houses of Morrowind are in upheaval.
Thank you.
have we here? Another plaything? You'll dance for me, little one. Yes, you will. I will make your corpse dance and then tear itself apart.